Welcome to Gein's Recital Hall on the campus of Campbellsville University and to the vote from our historic keyboard collection, which is a part of our School of Music. This collection consists of a harpsichord, a forte piano, several square grand pianos, a pipe organ, as well as a Steinway Model M studio piano. Some of you perhaps have saw these instruments back in 2014 when we hosted the Kentucky Music Teachers Conference on the occasion of the tricentennial of the birth of Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach. But for those who didn't get to hear it or to hear these instruments, let's start with the harpsichord and get just a little taste of what this instrument is like. This harpsichord was built by John Challis in the mid-20th century on commission from Professor Doris Bickel of the University of Louisville. It was used in her studio for lessons and on the concert stage for recitals and special events. Of the two manuals, the lower manual features 16, 8, and 4-foot stops. The upper manual features a nasar, a mute, and an 8-foot stop. Let's listen to an excerpt from one of Domenico Scarlatti's sonatas and see just a little what it looks like as one goes from manual to manual and hear a little of the effect. The replica of a 1790 forte piano built by Anton Walter in Vienna. Walter, along with Stein, were the two principal forte piano builders at this moment in time. Mozart is said to have owned a similar instrument to this one, as well as Beethoven in his earlier years. But it didn't take too long for Beethoven to outgrow this instrument and to demand a much larger one. This replica was built about 20 years ago or so by Thomas and Barbara Wolfe in Virginia, just outside Washington, D.C. It's a delicate instrument and it features pedals not at the feet, but played with the knee just below, as well as a mute. So for example, to have the pedal, one has to hold with the knee or the mute, you get the effect of what it's like. Let's listen to a little excerpt from one of Haydn's sonatas, just to give us a little flavor of the instrument. Thank you. we're now in the Vogue Farrar Historic Keyboard Room, and we're looking at a Knob and Gaelic instrument from about 1846. A little shorter keyboard, as might be imagined, and you'll notice that the strings are essentially horizontal to the player and to the keyboard. The instrument is the oldest in our collection, and it is one which is not particularly ornate, but is relatively easy to move. From here, we go over to our next instrument, which is an Eggert and Bobbitt. It's a rarer instrument. In fact, only two, or actually three more, are known to exist. Eggert and Bobbitt was a short-lived firm, and this instrument was built in the 1850s, just a few years before the American Civil War. As you can see, it's ornate with its legs, its design, the music stand, the candle holders on the sides. The strings, once again, are horizontal to the performer. The instrument does not have a full 88 keys, but it goes up actually pretty close to about 84, 85. I have to count them out to be absolutely sure. We know that the instrument was owned by this gentleman here, Robert Hunter, who in fact was a member of the United States Senate. During the Civil War, he sided with the Confederacy, being from Virginia, and he served in several positions in the Confederacy. Following that, he returned to Virginia and served as treasurer of the state. He bought this piano, we're told, documents have shown, I should say, for his four daughters, for them to learn to play. Both of these instruments were built in Baltimore, as well as our third square grand piano. This is a William Knob and Company. This instrument dates from 1887, approximately 1887. It too is quite ornate, as you might see, with horizontal strings, though some are cross-strung going in opposite directions here. It does have the full 88 keys to it, and the three instruments show the evolution of the square grand piano as it was being built in the 19th century. The Farrars were especially interested in 19th century instruments, and they not only collected keyboard instruments. Mr. Farrar once told me he had 20 pianos in his house, imagine that, but they also collected brass instruments, American-made brass instruments, and I understand they've donated those to the University of Illinois, where he taught musicology for many years. It's not a part of the collection, but we also have a pump organ, and this instrument is a Kimball pump organ made in Chicago in 1880. It has a number of different stops to it. A pump organ, it'll give you a full workout as you are dealing with it. This instrument was also a donation to Campbellsville University. The picture on the music stand is one of Doris Vogue's family when she was just a young girl. And she's the one on the left, and she has the two sisters as well, of course, as her parents that are here. We are especially grateful to the Farrars for donating these instruments, as well as the forte piano, which you heard a little earlier, and in a moment, a small pipe organ, which we'll see next door in Our Lady of Perpetual Help Catholic Church. We're now next door to the Gossett Fine Arts Center in Our Lady of Perpetual Help Catholic Church. It's quite a lengthy story, and if you would like to read it in detail, it's been published in the Campbellsville Review, which is available on the Campbellsville University website, of the events which led to the acquisition of this one-manual mechanical action Poppins pipe organ. It has 10 ranks. It was a gift of the Farrar family as well. And we have a happy marriage between the university and the church in that the university can use the instrument during the week and for concerts. The church uses the organ on Sunday and on special festive days. It features 10 stops, or ranks, I should say, and those give basic color here. Foundation, strings, and flutes. It's a delightful instrument. It fits the room perfectly in many ways. Let's listen to just a little excerpt here that will give us a taste of its sound. Stop by. We'd be glad to show you the instruments and let you play them. Thank you for watching.